Konnichiwa, Mina! And after a long season, it is time for the 2015 MTWS Runners-Up Cup. It was an incredible season this year. However, these trucks are the unfortunate 16 trucks that struggled all year and fell to this event. And as for the schedule tonight, first we'll be qualifying for the Runners-Up Cup, then we'll be racing, and immediately after that, we're going to tear down the track and put up the racing part of the 2015 championship up for the trucks competing at to qualify on, and then we'll rebuild the track for the Runners Up Cup for freestyle, and the Runners Up Cup trucks will go out there and freestyle, and then later on tonight we'll preview the racing bracket for the 2015 championship. So now let's see the unfortunate losers who have to be here. And the unfortunate screw-ups this year are Damage Control, Polar Storm, Topsy Turvy, Bone Crusher, Venom, War Machine, the majority of the rookie trucks are going to be here, Night Stalker, Ye Plunder, Predator, Locomotion, Topsy Turvy, Yatsura, Madness, and then the last three are quite surprising: Pokemon, Destroyer, and finally Shatter. All three of them I thought were going to make it to the championship this year. Alright, so here's the order for qualifying. It'll be Venom versus Nightstalker get big started, then War Machine versus Total Chaos, Bone Crusher versus Topsy Turvy, Predator versus Madness, Locomotion versus Deep Plunderer, Polar Storm versus Damage Control, Destroyer versus Yatsura, and then a huge showdown to finish it off: Pokemon Shatter. So let's get race qualifying underway. Alright, now to begin qualifying. Venom versus Nightstalker. This is Venom's first time ever racing on the Vegas-style track as they come out of Thunder Alley. And Venom looks like it has the slight lead. But they go to the turn. Venom with the slight lead, but took the turn really sharp. And they're going to hit the racing lane at the same time. It'll be a photo finish. And Venom with a 15.45 and Nightstalker with a 15.35. That's the time to beat. Not a bad time by both, indeed. And now here comes War Machine versus Total Chaos to take their first try on this trick. And Topsy Turvy is going to hit the wall and is way behind War Machine right now. Man, what a surprise this is. War Machine took both took a really sharp turn. That's not going to go well for the times as War Machine will get the win. And it's a 15.88 for War Machine and 16.43 for Topsy Turvy. Total Chaos. And speaking of Topsy Turvy, here it comes against Bone Crusher. Let's see how it does. Ooh, Topsy Turvy almost went to the wall there. Really slowed down a lot. And here we go. Bone Crusher with the lead, but took a very sharp turn. Topsy Turvy will come back and will easily get the win. And it's a 15.60 for Topsy Turvy and 15.85 for Bone Crusher. And now here we go. Here comes Predator and Madness. Two trucks have struggled really badly in racing so far this year. Both came out of Thunder Alley pretty slowly. And here we go to the turn. Predator with the lead. And a really good turn. Madness was going. Oh, Predator spun out and hit the double. How about that? Oh, man. That's probably going to be the slowest time for the night now. And it's going to be a 19.60 for Predator and Madness with a 15.40. Not bad. Got second place so far. Now that we hit the halfway point here, our two trucks have been to three straight as it goes into the wall. And Locomotion with a slight lead. But looks like Ye Plunder's coming back as Locomotion hits the turn first. Both had a great turn. And it'll be Locomotion with the victory. And it's a 15.30 for Locomotion, 15.83 for Ye Plunder. So Locomotion now has the lead. All right, now here we go with two other rookies, Damage Control and Polar Storm. See how they handle the turn? Ooh, Damage Control hit the chicanes going into Thunder Alley. Polar Storm has the lead so far. Here we go to the turn. A great turn by Polar Storm, although it was really slow. The Damage Control came back, but it'll be an easy victory for Polar Storm, and Polar Storm will get a 15.81 and Damage Control of a 15.92. All right, now here we go. Destroyer versus Yatsura. Very fast time for Destroyer coming out of Thunder Alley. Has a huge lead over Yatsura as we go to a turn. What a turn by Damn Destroyer! And will easily beat Yatsura. And will this be enough? And it will! A 14.55 for Destroyer and a 15.63 for Yatsura. Destroyer, with just one more run left to go, has the number one time right now. Alright, here we go for the final matchup. A big one too. Shatter versus Pokemon. Who will take out Destroyer's 14.55 as they're both almost even coming out of Thunder Alley? This could be a great turn here. A great turn by both Pokemon. Really sharp. And it's going to be a photo finish. What a race that was. And they're going to get number 2 and number 3 spots with Pokemon a 14.63 and Shadow with a 14.73. What a race that was. Well, after a disappointing year, so far Destroyer's got the night off right with the number 1 qualifying spot by just 800th of a second. But it's probably going to actually be kind of easy since Pokemon and Shatter are the only two real competitors with spot to win racing, and they're on the other side of the bracket and only got to face one of them. So this will be quite easy for Destroyer to probably make it to the finals tonight. So here's the results for qualifying. Alright, now here's the matchups for round 1. Destroyer versus Predator, Topsy Turvy versus Yatsura, Night Stalker versus Bone Crusher, Locomotion versus War Machine, Shatter versus Damage Control, Madness versus Ye Plunder, Venom versus Polar Storm, and Pokemon versus Total Chaos. So now, let's get racing underway. Alright, let's get racing underway. Here we go. Destroyer versus Predator. A nice turn. Ooh, Predator got really close to the wall there. Destroyer had a nice turn coming out of Thunder Alley. And here we go. Destroyer with a huge lead. Took a not really a good turn, but Destroyer will easily win. And now to face Destroyer in round 2 will be either Topsy Turvy or Yatsura. Let's see how they do. Ooh, Topsy Turvy. Oh, both hit the wall there. Wow, that's surprising there. Both struggled. And here we go. A nice turn by Topsy Turvy. And will easily beat Yatsura, but Yatsura really came back there. And now here we go for next matchup, Night Stalker and Bone Crusher. Oh, what a great, oh, damn it, a Bone Crusher spun out coming out of Thunder Alley. Night Stalker has a huge lead. And I was just about to say, Night Stalker had a great turn coming out of, going into Thunder Alley, and Night Stalker will get the victory there. And now for Locomotion versus War Machine. Another great turn there by Locomotion. And War Machine struggled going into Thunder Alley, but Locomotion has the lead so far. A great turn there, and Locomotion will get the victory. And we're now halfway through round 1 now, and next up is Shatter versus Damage Control. Oh, what a turn! Oh, Damage Control hit the chicanes there, and Shatter has a huge lead coming out of Thunder Alley. Here we go, it's gonna be a good turn. Not quite, as Damage Control even had a better turn, but it won't be enough to take out Shatter. And now it's Ye Plunder and Madness. Oh man, Ye Plunder really slowed down coming out of the turn, going into Thunder Alley. And Madness has the lead right now. And a great turn by Madness. And it'll be Madness with the victory. feel like you're running out of fuel. And now Venom versus Polar Storm. Ooh, Polar Storm hit the chicanes there, and Venom has the lead coming out of Thunder Alley. Two rookies not used his track, as both did not have a really good turn, but it'll be Venom with the victory. And now for the final match of round one, Pokemon versus Total Chaos. See how well they do? Ooh, Total Chaos really got close to the wall there, and Pokemon has a huge lead coming out of Thunder Alley. And now going to turn, what a turn there by Pokemon! Holy shit, that was great! And Pokemon will get the victory. Alright, now here's the matchups for round two, Destroyer versus Topsy Turvy, Nightstalker versus Locomotion, Shatter versus Madness, and Venom versus Pokemon. Let's get round two underway. And we're going to start off, like I said, Destroyer versus Topsy Turvy. Are they going to get out of... Ooh, Topsy Turvy slowed down a bit going into Thunder Alley, and Destroyer has a lead so far. And here we go to turn. Man, Topsy Turvy had a great turn, but it's not going to be enough to take out Destroyer. But man, Destroyer did not have a good turn there at all. And here we go, Nightstalker versus Locomotion. Great move coming out of Thunder Alley, going into Thunder Alley by Nightstalker, and has the lead as we go to the turn. Oh, great turn there by Nightstalker, almost spun out there, and Nightstalker is going on to the semifinals. How about that? And now, Madness versus Shatter. Oh, great going into Thunder Alley there by Madness, and they're dead even. How about that? Here we go to the turn. Oh, Madness went really wide, and Shatter took a sharp turn, and Shatter will hit the win as Madness goes up to double. How about that? Got a DNF there. And now for the final match of round two, Pokemon versus Venom. They are dead even, almost coming out of Thunder Alley. Slight edge to Pokemon. Here we go to turn. Another great turn by Pokemon. A good one though by Venom, but it won't be enough to take out Pokemon. Well, now the matchups for the semifinals is Destroyer versus Nightstalker and Shatter versus Pokemon. Let's get the semifinals underway. Here we go, Destroyer versus Nightstalker. They gotta get going to Thunder Alley perfectly, and they do. But Destroyer has the lead. Must have gone to the Thunder Alley really fast. Has the lead going to turn. Oh, what a turn by Destroyer, and Destroyer will easily beat Nightstalker. So now, who will Destroyer face? The big showdown, Shatter versus Pokemon. And they both go into Thunder Alley beautifully, and they're coming out at dead even. And there they go to the turn. Great. Oh, Shatter went really wide. What a great turn, but Shatter will get it. Well, for the third runners-up cup in a row, I predicted the finals correctly. But then again, it's not really a surprise since most of the trucks in this event are pretty terrible at winning events. And there's like maybe like one or two that you are, so it's easy for that to happen. So this year, two trucks that fell so short for the championship, Destroyer and Shatter. Remember, Shatter was just one point short of making it to the championship. And same goes for Destroyer. They did pretty good in their last event in El Paso, but fucked up in freestyle badly, which blew their chances. So now, it's going to come down to this. Who will win this year's Runners-Up Cup racing part? Destroyer or Shatter? Here we go. And here we go for the finals. Destroyer versus Pokemon Shatter. Here they come. Down Thunder Alley. Shatter hit the wall. And Destroyer has a slight lead coming out of down Thunder Alley. Here we go to the turn. They're nearly dead even. Great turn there by Shatter! They're gonna hit the lane at the same time, and it's a photo! What an unbelievable race that was! And here's the photo of the finish! Now, just to let you know, it's not aimed correctly on straight line, so although Destroyer looks like it crossed the finish line first, it didn't. They crossed exactly at the same time, and here are the times. And look at this! Shatter will win racing by 1/100th of a second! Damn, what a race that was! Unbelievable finish by Shatter racing tonight. And congratulations to Shatter winning the 2015 MTWS Runners Up Cup racing win. But now it's gonna celebrate with a donut. But I'm sure we wish this was the racing title for next week instead. But hey, this is just as good. And now probably plan on what they're going to do to possibly go for the double down. And not a bad run so far tonight by Destroyer, number one in racing, I mean number one in qualifying, and runner-up in the finals by 1/100 of a second. That was a very good performance. I bet wish it did that for the entire season, though, and if it did, it would have made it to the championship. Well, here's the results for racing. Tonight we rise. Tonight we rise. Like a hand grenade, thrown in a hurricane, spinning in chaos, trying to escape the flame. But now, before we begin freestyle, it's time for the qualifying for the 2015 championship. The track's all been torn up and we put the racing part out, so let's see the order for freestyle that was randomly drawn. And here's the order for qualifying. How about this? Eruption, who has gotten number one qualifying the last 2 years, is going to come out first. Now remember, the trucks that usually come out first do not do so well in qualifying, so let's see how well this goes. Here comes Eruption to start qualifying. Alright, here we go to start qualifying. Here comes Eruption, going right to Thunder Alley. A perfect turn going into Thunder Alley, now out in the track. Off to a great start so far, but here we go to the turn. A great turn, but not as good as it could be. Almost hit the jersey barriers, and gonna get across the line. So let's see the time to beat, and it's a 15.19 for Eruption. Time to beat, but not quite as fast as it hoped for. Alright, now first up to challenge Eruption's time is Fireball, who made it all the way to the semifinals last year. And nice turn, almost hit the wall going into Thunder Alley 2. And here we go to the turn. A great turn by Fireball. This should easily beat the time. What air that was! And it's a 14.83. That is the new fast time to beat. And now here comes the truck who won the Runners-Up Cup racing part last year, Flying Falcon, who's returned to the championship after a year away. Great turn going into Thunder Alley. And here we go down the straightaway. Here we go to the turn. Went really wide there. Screwed up big time there. Almost hit the center... I can't even get anything right, and it's a terrible 15.73 for Flying Falcon. That's dead last so far. And now here comes the first of our championship rookies, Outrage, to see how it does this first ever race in the championship. Nice turn going into Thunder Alley. Now on the track to see how it manages that crucial turn. Went deep, handle it. Ooh, hit the jersey walls there. Probably gonna be around a time below Eruption. And it's going to be a... Ooh, damn! Last place, 16.12. Who would have thought? All right, now here comes another championship rookie, Stinger, going to go on the track, who just barely made it in after struggling in El Paso as it hit the wall going into Thunder Alley. See how it does in the turn here. Since Outrage somewhat struggled. A good turn by Stinger there. I can't wait to see his time. This will be interesting. They are a 15.85, so still not really a good time overall, but that was still a pretty good turn. And now, for the 5 straight trucks in a row, a matchup of veterans in racing, and we'll start off with the defending racing champion, Crush and Run. Let's see how it does. It struggled in racing the last bit of the second half of the season. Let's see how it does here in the turn. A beautiful turn! Brilliantly! Will this get number one? It hits the jersey wall there, and it's... just enough! 14.78! Crush and Run is the new leader. And now here comes the 2-time racing champion, Outlaw, who fell short last year. Oh, great turn going to Thunder Alley. Trying to beat Crush and Run's time, and so far off to a good start. Here we go into the turn. Oh, what a beautiful turn that was! Oh, could this be enough to take out Crush and Run? And it will! A new fast time of 14.49. That might have been the fastest time ever as well.
All right, now here comes the 2011 racing runner-up Impala. Let's see how it does. Very disappointed how it finished in racing last year, but so far off to a good start. Here we go to the final turn. A great turn. Oh, went really wide there. Ooh, hit the jersey wall there. Hope it doesn't screw up its run, which it probably will. And it's going to be a 15.22 for Impala, so that did screw it up quite a lot. All right, now here comes another great racer, Thunderbolt. Let's see how it does. Remember, flipped in racing last year. Off to a great start with that great turn. It's now come out of Thunder Alley. Here we go to the turn. Oh, another beautiful turn that was. Will this be enough to challenge Outlaw? Oh, second place at 14.72. How about that? Thunderbolt now has the second fastest time so far.
And now here comes the 2011 racing champion Power Forward on the track, who had a great run. Ooh, hit the wall there. Had a great performance in El Paso and race, and hoping to keep that momentum up to get another championship. Here we go into the turn. Oh, went really wide. Oh, spun out a bit there. Oh boy, this may not be a good time at all. And here it is. It's a 15.43. Oh man, that was just very disappointing for Power Forward. And now here comes a truck that just barely made it into the championship, Crazy, who still remains, I think, like 5 or 6 trucks that made it to every single championship as it flies out of Thunder Alley. Here we go to the turn. Went really deep, but not no surprise because Crazy is not that good at racing. And let's see. It will be a 15.61 for Crazy. And now here comes one of the two champ rookies literally competing tonight, Monster Jam. Let's see how well it does tonight. Can it take out Outlaw's 14.49? Here we go to the turn. Oh, what a great turn that was by Monster Jam, but slow down a lot going to the first turn, so that might hurt a little bit. And it's going to be a 14.77. I think that's third place. Not a bad run indeed for the rookie. And now here comes Shadowrun. Let's see how it does in the turn. It's really slow and really wide that turn, and now it's coming out of Thunder Alley. Here we go to the turn. Oh man, really deep in that one. And now I'm gonna go right for racing lane. Some huge and beautiful air. And it'll be a 15.86 for Shadowrun. And now up is the Monster Razor, who's returned after a year away. Let's see how well it does here. As it, ooh, hits the wall going into Thunder Alley. Now here we go to the turn. Let's see how well it does. Oh, another great turn, but not as good as it probably would want. Probably not gonna be a very good time. It's going to be a 15.36. Not really that good, though. And now here comes Patriot. There we go to the turn. Oh, what a great turn that was going into Thunder Alley. Now flying out of Thunder Alley. Could this be a challenge to Outlaw? Here we go to the turn. Oh, a beautiful turn. But it did go kind of wide. It didn't take a sharp turn like Outlaw did. And it's going to be a 14.81, which, if I'm correct, should be fifth place so far. Alright, here we go. Another truck that struggled in championships and racing so far in its history. Here comes Wild Ride as it flies out of Thunder Alley. Here we go to the turn. Oh, went really steep into it, so it's not going to probably be a good time as it goes into the other lane almost. And it's going to be a 15.45, so yeah, not a good time at all. And now here comes the 2009 Freestyle Champion Mad Dog, who was also the 2010 racing runner-up, losing to a photo finish almost to Nitro as it flies out of Thunder Alley. Been inconsistent racing so far as it takes, ooh, really went deep in that turn, so probably not going to be a good time to take out Outlaw, but got some nice air. So let's see, it's going to be a, ooh, 14.98, that could still be in the top 8 so far. And now here's 2009 racing runner-up Crazy Bull, who's one of my favorites to win racing tonight. Now let's see, can it be enough to take out Outlaw's time as it comes out of Thunder Alley? Here we go to the turn. Oh, a brilliant turn. Ooh, got went to the lane. Oh, got caught by the... Oh, boy, this could probably screw up the time. Oh, man, only a 15.66 for Crazy Bull. Took the turn too sharp and lost control and went up that lane. Oh, man, that sucks. All right, now here comes another rookie, Red Alert. And take a look at this. Look at this new flag I put up. Bernie fucking Sanders, bitches. As Red Alert comes onto the track. We'll take it. Ooh, went really stalled there in the turn. We took a really steep turn there. And here we go. Nice air off the racing lane. and it's going to be a 15.70 for Red Alert. Kind of disappointing. And now here comes Blood Rage, who was a former qualifying number one spotter. And let's see how it comes out flying out of Thunder Alley. Still no one's fouled Outlaws. Ooh, took a nice turn here, but didn't seem to be sharp enough to take out Outlaw. And here's the time. It's a 14.90. So it could possibly be going into in the top eight, but not enough to take out Outlaw. We are now down to the final four qualifiers, and next up is Crusher, who just also, ooh, hit the wall there, who also is another truck that just barely got into the championship. Let's see how it does. Took a sharp turn, but very slow. Same, ooh, went up that ramp there. That's not going to be good. If it land on the ramp there, it's going to be a 15.75 for Crusher. That's pretty disappointing. All right, now here comes Prowler. Nice coming at, going to the Thunder Alley. Here we go to the turn. A nice turn, but it was still kind of slow, so it might not be enough. But some nice air off the racing lane, and it's going to be a 15.08. Yep, it's a sharp turn, but they need to go out, come into it a lot faster to beat Outlaw's time. Now here we go to the final two trucks, and here comes Bling. Also barely got in after win freestyle in El Paso. They come flying out of Thunder Alley beautifully. So here we go into the final turn. Oh man, went really steep there. But it's gonna get a lot of speed, and it's gonna get some beautiful air off the racing lane. And it's gonna, oh, it landed on the ramp there. It's gonna be a 14.98 for Bling. This could challenge to get into the top eight though. Well, now it's come down to this. Outlaw, the 2010 racing champion, who got number one qualifying that year as well, has struggled very badly in racing so far this year, but it's always been very good here in the championship, or in Vegas at least, but did not do a good turn there at all. So this is probably not going to be anywhere near close to top 8, and will not be. It's only going to be a 15.08 for Nitro, as the struggle still continues in racing. Congratulations, Outlaw, on getting the 2015 championship number one qualifying spot for the first time ever. But you gotta remember, outside of Eruption last year, the number one qualifier has either gone all the way to win the title like Nitro did in 2010, but the other three times they were knocked out in round two. They were one and done. So history doesn't look good for Outlaw, but hey, anything can happen. So here's the results for qualifying, and remember, the top eight go straight in round two. So congratulations to Outlaw, Thunderbolt, Monster Jam, Crush and Run, Patriot, Fireball, Blood Rage, and Mad Dog for getting the top eight spots, and they'll go directly in round two. And since Outlaw and Crush and Run will be on the exact same bracket this time, they will not meet this time in the final. They can meet in semifinals, so we're going to have a different finals matchup from the last 2 years, so that'll be quite interesting. But we'll not reveal the bracket yet. That's going to be for later tonight to get you all anticipated for the championship. So next is freestyle for the Runners Up Cup. So here's the order for freestyle. All right, now to start off freestyle, and here comes Damage Control. Gonna go right for the van, and freestyle is now underway with some nice air off the vans. So now what will Damage Control do now? On probably the biggest track it's seen since its debut in Atlanta. Gonna go right for the racing lane, got some nice air, but got caught by the hole in between the gap you can't see. And gonna go right up the vans. Some beautiful air that was. Ooh, got close to the barriers there. And now gonna go for the vans over there.
There's like four van stacks out there, ain't that something? That will it do. It's gonna line up for the bus stack. I'm gonna get some nice air. Off to a great start so far. Now it looks like it's gonna line up for the vans as it almost hit the barriers again. Oh, some beautiful air off the vans that was. And now we're in halfway through regulation. Gonna crawl up. Ooh, got caught by the boxes there. And gonna go down the center jump. And now gonna go for the bus again. Gonna cross thread it and gonna land right down on the racing lane. So now down to the final 30 seconds. Is it lined up for the step up? Yep, it is. Here we go. Beautiful air off of it. And now gonna go right back for the racing lane. Oh, got some big air off of it. The biggest distance so far. So now what we'll do, what's it doing? Ooh, hit the wall. Got final 10 seconds left. Oh, it's lined up for the backflip for the first time ever. It's never done a backflip before. And Azugoy! Damage Control's first ever backflip, as now we're in bonus time. Oh, that move might have counted towards regulation as it jumps the van stack and lands right on the car. What a run so far by Damage Control. This is Damage Control's best run ever. This might be lean for a while. Uh-oh, got going off the side of the center jump, but managed to get down. So now what's it gonna do? Oh man, this is great. Gonna crush the vans over there. Gotta hurry, only got 4 seconds left. They're gonna line up for the semi-trailer and just get it off in time. Some nice air. And that will be the end for bonus time. So now what's gonna do? Gonna go right up the double. I mean, yeah, the double. And got some nice air off that side. And now, gonna go right for the center stack. And it's gonna park it there. What a great run that was by Damage Control. I can't wait to see his scores. This should be lean for a while. A 25 in regulation, 2 bonus points, and Damage Control will take the lead with a 27, the highest scoring run ever for it. Here comes Polar Storm on the track to take out Damage Control's 27, and also gonna go right for the vans. Some nice air. So now what's it gonna do? Is it goes lines up, came to stop. Now gonna go for the racing lane, and will it clear it up? Nope, not quite. But that was the biggest jump so far from that side. It got some nice air off the vans, getting close to the containers there, and now gonna go right for the vans again. Some more. Can't wait for someone to hit the other side. So now, what will it do? Looks like line up for the buses. Oh, going to a donut, but it's not in a good spot to do it. Getting close to the center jump. And now gonna line up for the center jump. Trying to cross thread, but got caught off the side there. And got caught there as well. As we're now nearly halfway through the run. Now line up for the semi-trailer. And gonna hit the steep side. Beautiful sky wheelie there. Kind of like Hot Wheels in World Finals 14. And now gonna go up the double again. Just crawled up it this time. And now we're down to the final 30 seconds. And now gonna go right back for the center jump some more as it crawls down it. And now gonna crawl up the vans as it got caught there. So with just 15 seconds left. Ooh, hit the wall there. Didn't have to back up, so that's good. Now gonna go for the vans. Oh, up the side. Oh, going over. Oh man, that sucked. Had 9 seconds left. Oh boy, so let's see how low this will be for Polar Storm. And it's a 22 for Polar Storm. So far, the lowest score of the night. Alright, now here comes Polar Chaos on track. Gonna get some nice air off the semi-trailer. How about that for a start? And now gonna go right for the center. Oh, nice sky wheelie! Down the center jump! Damn, what a start by Total Chaos so far! And now gonna go right for the double and crawls up it, crawls up the other one. Man, what a start to freestyle this was. Had a good run last weekend, a couple weeks ago in El Paso. Oh, nice air off the van. And nice air off the racing lane. Oh, got caught there, but managed to get off. Damn, what a start this is. And now gonna go right for the buses. Oh, beautiful sky wheelie that was. Now gonna line up right for the step up. That's gonna be very hard to set up right from it when you go from that side. You gotta make that perfect steep turn. Oh, nosedive it right into the ground. Already halfway through the run, put up a great run as we're now into a donut. And this is came to a stop. It was perfect to continue going though. And gonna get some nice air off the vans and hits the buses and hits the vans that side for the first time. And now down to 24 seconds. Should have gone for a similar trail. That could have gotten some more points. Oh, nice air off the vans. The biggest distance so far. Now what's it gonna do? Oh, it's gonna go for the fifth wheel. I'm backflipping the first time ever. And Azukoi, the first ever backflip by Total Chaos. And now I'm gonna line up for a double. Will it clear it? And Azukoi cleared the double. And gonna go for the semi trailer. And plows right through into a beautiful sky wheelie. Ooh, what I landed on the ground. And now what's it gonna do is it's gonna reverse. That's gonna cost a lot of points as it goes into bonus time. Damn, what a run this is by Total Chaos. This should be leading for a while. Oh, nice wheelie. Up, oh, went up the side. Nice save there by Total Chaos. Damn, what a run this is. And now gonna hit the vans. A bus deck, gonna cross friend. Lands right in the center of the track. Going up the vans. Gotta hurry though, only got a few seconds left. This won't count towards regulation, but gonna go for the side of the track. Oh, going up the side and gonna go over. Oh my god. What a run this was by Total Chaos! This is the best run ever! I can't wait to see how much it blows past damage control for the lead. Oh, this is bullshit! Only a 26 in regulation, 2 bonus points. Total Chaos will take the lead by 28, but man, that was awfully short. Now, first to take up Total Chaos's 28 is Venom. Is going to go right for a semi trailer. Oh, it's going off the side. On all two wheels. Oh, nice save there. You got to be careful when you line up. It's not a perfect angle for that box. And now going to crawl up the doubles. Man, I still can't believe how little Total Chaos got. That was bullshit. Oh, nice air off the center jump. And didn't get caught by the racing lane there. That was a great move there. And now going to go right up the vans. And now gonna line up for the step up. And looks like gonna line up perfectly for the vans. Up, oh, no, just missed it. And now gonna go right for the buses. And just crawled up it. Now what's it gonna do? Gonna go right for the racing lane again. And nice crossbat. Ooh, went off the side a bit there. Now what's it gonna do? Gonna line up for step up again. Oh, gonna go right for the vans. Oh, the biggest distance so far from that side. So now, what will this beautiful truck do? Gonna go right for the racing lane again. Nice there. And now gonna go up the steep side of step up the first time tonight. And got some nice distance off of it. And we're now down to 23 seconds left in regulation. Gonna go right for the semi-trailer. That was risky hitting it from that angle because it could have been caught. But managed to get it off. And now gonna cross right off the double right onto the racing lane. Final 10 seconds left of regulation. Put up a big run so far. Now what's he gonna do? Crawl up the double again. Stuffs into right into the ramp. Will hit the vans in time, and yes it will. That'll be the final move for regulation. Now we're in bonus time. Ooh, hit the wall hard. There doesn't seem to be any damage. No four link broken, so we can keep going. And now gonna go right up the step up some more. That did do some damage to the front end, but not too serious. And now gonna go up the center jump. And now going into a donut, but getting close to the wall. Hit the wall there. And now going to go for the double. and got a crossbred onto the racing lane, and that will be it for regulation, bonus time. So now what will it do? Ooh, hit the container there, and now gonna go up the van stack. Oh, it's gonna park it there. Oh man, what a run that was by Venom. But that definitely won't be enough to take out Total Chaos. A great run, but it's only going to be a 23 in regulation plus 2 bonus points, and Venom will get third place with 25. A quarter of the way through in freestyle, and Total Chaos leads by 1 point for 28. Now, here comes War Machine. And now here comes War Machine on the track, and what will it do is it's going to go right for the vans. Nope, it's going to go right for the double and going to cross-thread right onto the racing lane. Uh-oh, got caught there. Well, now what will it do? And now it's going to line up for the racing lane. Uh-oh, beautiful air. And now going to go right for the van stack. Ooh, hit the barriers there. And now going to line up for the step up. Remember that incredible run it had to start off the season in Oakland? Didn't put up anything quite as big since then, which is kind of disappointing. That would have really helped it find a championship. Now it goes up to double, crushes that other buses, and now going to... Man, for a minute there, I thought it was going to go up the semi trip, but all of a sudden came to a stop and didn't do it. So that's going to hurt in terms of points, as we're now halfway through the run. Going to combo it up the van and crushes that other van, and now into his wheelie. Oh, got caught off the side. Now going to go up the buses. Be careful, because... could have usually would probably flip there, and now gonna combo up the vans again, beautiful, and now gonna really combo up the step up into a beautiful sky wheelie. Oh, hit the barriers there, had to reverse again. This is not gonna be a good score if it keeps reversing. So now what we'll do, go right back for the double. Oh, some nice air, stuffs it right into the ramp there. Now from in there, phone's gonna go for the backflip, but no, now I'm gonna go right for the center jump. Oh, beautiful air. Ooh, got caught twice there by the racing lane. Oh, nice air off the vans. And now we're in bonus time. Looks like gonna line up right for the semi-trailer. Oh, beautiful sky wheelie that is. And now more beautiful air that goes right back for the double some more. Don't need the wow factor yet, which has yet to do. And it's slowing down an awful lot. Oh, nice air off the race lane. Went off the side a bit. Now what's he gonna do? Line up for the step up again. What's he gonna do? Oh, it's gonna reverse up the step up. How about that? But oh, got caught. You better be careful. Because remember, that happened to Predator and Foxborough at the beginning of the year, where reversed up the step up and actually got caught and flipped over. And now what will War Machine do? Gonna go right for the race, the center jump. Oh, nice there, there. As it goes off the side. Man, what an incredible run this is. Now it looks like it's gonna park on the buses. Man, what an incredible run this was by War Machine, but it did slow down an awful lot, so that's not going to help in terms of scoring. It's a 22 in regulation, 2 bonus points, and War Machine will only get a 24. Alright, now out on the track is Bone Crusher, and gonna go right for the vans. Oh, got some nice distance there. Now, what will it do? Line up for the bus, the double? Yep, here we go. Just gonna crawl up them. Though I haven't seen as much aggression from these trucks besides damage control and Total Chaos. Ooh, hit the wall, the barriers there by Bone Crusher. And now gonna go right up the step up. Oh, beautiful air that was. So now it's gonna go right for the buses. And just crawled up it. There, we haven't gotten any real wheelies yet. Oh, got caught by the tape, the step. I can't get anything right. Now halfway through the run. Now it's gonna go line up for the semi so we can get a beautiful sky wheelie here. Oh yes, beautiful air that was. And now I'm gonna go right back for the double some more. Better be careful, because getting really close to the edge. Now looks like it's gonna cross red here. And lands right on the right. Ooh, hit the side of the bus, so it didn't fully got off of it that time. And now gonna go right up the tabletop. Just 14 seconds left. And now gonna go right back to the racing lane. And cleared it. How about that? That was the biggest jump from that side. And now gonna line for the buses again. Now getting some aggression out there. And it's gonna land right down on the racing lane. And we're now in bonus time. And gonna go right for the van some more. And they got a nice nosedive almost there. Hit the barriers there as well. And now gonna hit the steep, the other side of the semi-trailer. Oh, nice air off the racing. Ooh, got caught. Finally got off. Ooh, hit the racing lane there. And now gonna go right back for the double some more. Ooh, but gonna go off the side a bit there. Better hurry. Ooh, hit the side of the van. And that will be the end for bonus time. Oh, nice air off the double and almost cleared it. How about that? Ooh, goes right into the wall. How about that? What a strange finish that was. But at least it didn't do that much damage. And now for the scores, it is a 23 in regulation, 2 bonus points, and Bone Crusher gets a 25. Not bad. Now here comes Night Stalker, a truck that has struggled a lot in freestyle shirt, flipping way too early. Got some nice air to start off with off the vans. Now gonna go right for the racing lane. Oh, got some nice air and almost cleared it. So off to a great start so far, coming out with a lot of aggression. Which has done these last few weeks. Remember that sick run it did in New Orleans a month ago? That was a great run. Got some nice air off the step up there. And now gonna go right for the van. Ooh, nice nosedive that was. So now what will it do? Gonna go right back to the racing lane some more. Uh-oh, got caught there. And now gonna go right for the van. Oh no, I'm with 2 wheels! Oh, gonna go over and go right to the barriers there. Oh man, what a crazy finish that was. But once again, flipped way too early again. That's happened all year mostly for Night Stalker, and it will only be a 10. And now here comes the Repton track, coming up with some high speed here. How about that? Some nice aggression to start things off. Oh, beautiful air off the racing lane. I mean, the double as it lands right on the ending lamp of the racing lane. How about that? And now gonna go right for the van. I mean, the bus deck got some huge air there off that side. I think that's the biggest air anyone's got from that angle. And now with a lot of aggression, took a nice turn and went right up the step with some nice air. And just gonna stuff it into the race, the tabletop there. Man, what an aggressive start Madness is coming out with. Slow down a bit though as it went up the double. But it's gonna keep it. And it's gonna go right for the cemetery. Oh, beautiful sky wheelie there. And lands right on the ground hard. Damn, what a run this is so far. Oh, beautiful air off the vans. That thing else is more distance than the double. Oh, gonna go right for the backflip. And here we go. Up and very quick. And Asugoi! Another backflip for the night, And now going to go right for the racing lane. Oh, you did off the racing lane. That's the, probably the biggest distance anyone's got from that spot. And now what's it going to do? That's going to be very risky going for the cemetery that way, but it succeeds and got a nice sky wheelie there. Man, what a run this is. Oh, beautiful sky wheelie there, but you better slow down, get close to the wall, and hit the wall there, but didn't let, wasn't enough to keep it from going forward instead of reversing. And now I'm going to go off the cemetery, oh no, off the wheels, nice save. What a save though, ooh, hit the wall, and now in bonus time. Damn, what a run this is by Madness. More huge here off the fans. Should have tried to go in for a wheelie there, though, because they had the distance to try a little one. And now what we'll do? Oh, going to go right back for another backflip. The thing is, the second one. Yeah, this is the first time anyone's done it twice, but it wasn't as good as the last one. And now going to go right for the fans. Oh, beautiful air. And, oh, well, it might have actually landed right on the fans going down, the landing part. Better hurry, only got enough time. And, oh, I'm not sure. That might not have counted. We're going to have to find out. Because, boy, was that very, very close. And going to a donut and hit the wall there. And going into another donut. Damn, this is great. The first cyclone of the night. Now, going to go right up the tabletop. And it's going to park it there. Unbelievable run by Madness that was. This is going to be leading probably for a long time, knowing the talent pool for tonight. Oh, I can't wait to see his scores. This is sick. A 30 in regulation, 3 bonus points, and Madness will take a 5-point lead with a 33. Great run there by Madness. So now, halfway through freestyle, and Madness leads with a 33. Back to freestyle, here comes G Plunder. Alright, now here comes Eruption on the track. And as its signature MO, gonna go right for what the van stick. Oh, going up the side, better be careful because you don't want the clock to start. And there we go, as it got some nice air off the vans. And now gonna go for the other van. Oh, some big air off of it. How about that? And now gonna go right for the double. Very inconsistent freestyle this year. And that's why it's not into the championship. Oh, Bugier off the van. Now going after the semi-trailer. We can get a nice skywheel. Yep, but not quite as much air like everyone else was getting. Oh, going to cross right onto the racing lane. How about that? Still keep going after halfway through the run. Now going to go for the double and going off the side. First time anyone's done that. Now going right back for the vans. I think that's like only the second time anyone's hit from that side. And now going right back for the van some more. Up the double in the racing lane. And didn't get caught once. That was fantastic. Nice and fast down. And now going to go right for the buses. For a minute there, Paul was going to cross for, but it like changed his mind. And now for the third time hitting the vans, that one in particular, and now going to go up the step up. I bet G-Plant wish he could have had a run like this all year. Who got caught, and now in bonus time. So here we go, another backflip. Might have been G-Plant's first now. I think he did one in Atlanta, but now going to get some huge air off the racing lane. Nice. And more beautiful air off the vans. Just 10 seconds left in bonus time. Is it going to go up the other side of the semi-trailer? And now going to get more air off the racing lane. And that will be it for bonus time. What a great run this was by Ye Plunder. Ooh, nice air off the step up. Yeah, step up. And goes almost into the wall and has to reverse. And now what we'll do, go right for the vans, they're gonna park it there. Well, another great run for Ye Plunder, which had rare opportunities last this season. Let's see the score, though. A 26 in regulation, 2 bonus points, and Ye Plunder gets a 28. Now, here comes Reverser King Predator, gonna get some huge speed going right for the semi-trailer. Oh, damn, what a start that is to beat the all-nice wheelie up the racing lane. How about that to start off freestyle? Struggled a lot in freestyle this year, although did get a lot of Reverser backflips in. Oh, nice there off the bus. The double as it landed. Oh, actually cleared the racing lane. How about that? Don't think it won a single race this year. Oh, nice skywheelie that was. And struggling freestyle, that's why after making it to the championship event last year, Fred is going to fall short this year. And off to a great start, is going to go right for the bus and some more. Now what we'll do, go right for the step up. We'll see the biggest distance so far. Beautiful air that was. We're halfway through the run. Ooh, going to go up right up the tabletop. Oh, going off the side, and nice. Ooh, stuffed into the buses almost. At the reverse there. Now what? Oh, here we go. Gonna go for the reverse backflip. Here we go. Oh, went off the side. And gonna go over. Oh man. So this is now, I think like three out of four times now that Fredder has failed the reverse backflip. How about that? Because Fredder's only failed once in the last couple of years, and now it's failed 3 times now in a month. And it's only going to be a 28. All right, now here we go. The final commentary that I have to redo because of locomotion. And yay, finally done. But remember, you can go watch the original video with the original commentary. And of course, more importantly, the original locomotion's original theme, Crazy Train, in the description of this video. Not description, I mean the comments. I'll have it pinged where you can download and watch the original. So, hope you all enjoy watching that. Sorry I have to watch this again, of course. Fucking have to redo it all because of Crazy Train. And here we go. Here comes Locomotion to take on Madness and gonna go right for the Metal Militia jump. Huge air off of it and gonna go into center jump. Oh, spun out. Which actually happened a lot both that night, I think, and in the championship the next week. As score to beat was a 33 by Madness. Gonna go for the cross thread over the race lane from the double. As now right for that bus stack, the van stack right in the middle. As we'll now line up right for the the semi-trailer where the step upside, because that backflip wall, that semi-trailer there is not for backflipping, because it used to be for, but not really after the new setup I had at the time, so I couldn't do that anymore. Now we'll line up right for the center jump, and we'll land right on top of it, nosedive coming down, almost halfway through regulation, right for the back of the step up, nice air off of it, good run so far, take on Madness's 32. Gotta keep that aggression up though, as we'll now go right for the bus deck. Some nice air off of it. Coming down, ooh, hard hit. Now we'll line up right for, ooh, slow down a little bit. Gonna go right for the backflip wall, here we go. And we'll just get it, nice. Good run, now line up for the bus deck. Gonna go for full throttle. Oh, could have cleared the van stack, and we'll, yeah, clear the bus, nice. That might have, I don't think that was the first time, I think someone did earlier. I have no idea because I didn't watch this video, I had to redo the commentary. Nice air off the step up, final 11 seconds of regulation, gonna go cross thread over the center jump, going down that hill, as now maybe line up for the double, sliding out, here we go. This is gonna be it for regulation, oh, just gonna crawl over it, gonna go over the bus, and that is it. We're now in bonus time for locomotion. Got the pup run, help a bonus time, here we go, backside of the semi-trailer, nice. Hard bounce you saw right there coming down. Now we'll line up right for the center jump. Nice air off of it. We'll go now line up right for the back of the center jump once again. As nosedive it. Time wind down. 10 seconds left of bonus time for locomotion. Gonna go for the bus stack. Nice cross, Fred. Hard hit. As now going right for the semi-trailer. Just in time. Let's see what happens here on Landon. And that will be it for bonus time for locomotion. Still going on, though. Right for the bus stack. I mean, not the bus stack. The van stack, I mean to say. Gonna go into the side of the hill right there. Ooh, stuffed it hard into the bus stack right there. Really hard hit. As now, what's locomotion gonna do? Right for the racing lane. Nice air off of it. And gonna park it right in the middle of the track. What a run that was by locomotion. Will it be enough to take on that furry free by Madness? It's gonna be close. That was a good run too. I believe at the time, and possibly still right now, this might have been the best run locomotion ever had as a score coming in. It's a 29 regulation plus 3 bonus points, and locomotion will get a 32 second place. Now up is a truck who made it to the championship last year but fell short this year, and that's Topsy Turvy. Gonna go right for the Vans. Got some nice air getting things started. And now going to a donut, but getting awfully close to the semi-truck. I'm back for the container. Now going right for the right tabletop. Oh, nice air there it was. Oh, nice nosedive there. Very disappointed how the season ended up. It had a shot to make it to the championship, but outright blew it. And now we're racing the Vans on nice air. Now going right for the double. Oh, nice. Nose dive. That was another one. How about that? And now going right for the racing lane. Oh, nice there. Who got caught and meant to get off. Now well, we're going to line for the buses, but couldn't line up correctly in time. And now going right for the buses this time. Going to crawl up it. And now going right for the Vans. Gonna combo it up into the other van. Oh no, onto the wheels, nice save. That was beautiful. Just the final 30 seconds left of regulation. Oh, nice air there off the race lanes. It goes right for the tabletop as well. Now, what we'll do right for the race in the van stack. And now right for the semi-trailer. And beautiful sky wheelie that was. And now up the double some more. And they got caught for a second there. And now in bonus time. What will it do? Walker may have been going for the backflip, but didn't. Oh, nice hitter off the racing lane. That was great. Now, ooh, almost hit the wall there. Now going right for the step up. I'm going right for the racing lane again some more. Better hurry. I only got a few seconds left. Got to put up something big. They're going to crawl up the buses and land right on the pad down to the racing lane. Now it's build a clock. And now going right for the semi-trailer. Oh, got caught. It seems the semi-trailer's collapsed. Oh, no, on one wheel and going to go over. After an incredible finish that was. Well, most certainly was better than its running the championship last year. But that surely won't be enough to take out Madness. Scores are in, a 25 in regulation, 2 bonus points, and Topsy Turvy gets a 27. Down to the final 4 trucks, and Madness still leads with a 33. Here comes Yatsura. It's hard to explain how things have changed, but I'm not the same as before, and I know there's so much more ahead. I can barely believe that I'm here, and I won't surrender quietly. And now here comes one of the more popular rookie trucks in the league. Yatsura going right for semi-trail. Oh, going up the side on 2 wheels. Nice save. What a start there for Yatsura. Had an incredible run, remember, 2 months ago when
That was 3 months ago in Mexico City, where it actually led for a bit. It had some great, incredible runs this year. And so far off to a great start with that nice air off the racing lane, and now going right for the step up. Nice so far. So now what's it going to do? Going to have a tough road to beat. The beat Madness is 33. Oh, nice air off the racing lane. Cleared it perfectly. So now going to go right for the Vans. Oh, just beautifully plowed right through him. Oh, God, if only we could see him actually get crushed down. And now going to go right for the Vans deck, but better be careful getting close to Sias. We're now halfway through the run. And now going to go right for the tabletop. Oh, going to go up the side, but nose dives it. So now going to line up for going for the double. Yep, here we go. And it will. Oh, just cleared it. Actually landed rear wheel first in the last car. So it didn't quite clear, but came very, very close. Oh, another beautiful air off the step up again. So now going to go right back for the race on buses. What a great run this is. Oh, and yep, here we go. Yatsura's second ever backflip. Lands it perfectly too. What an incredible run this is. And now going back for the racing lane again. Went off the side a little bit from that quick, weird landing. And now in bonus time. And Yatsura's putting up a run. But I don't think it's going to be enough to take out Madness. This is 33. Ooh, stuffs it into the tabletop. Oh, and two wheels. Nice. Man, what a move that was. That's MTM2 physics view. Ooh, stuffed into the ground there. And now going to go for a double as it's going to try and cross right here. Ooh, it got caught by the boxes down there. Oh, it's caught. And it's going to go right into the double. And it's going to a stop. It's stuck. Unfortunately, it got stuck by the boxes that you can't see. But it did put up a good run nonetheless. Not impressive run that was by Yatsura. Can't wait to see his scores. A 26 in regulation plus one bonus point. That's awfully low. Yatsura will only get a 27. Really stingy there. And now here comes Shatter, who is the only one capable of going for double down. Gonna go right for a double, and beautiful air to get things started into a crossfit over the racing lane. What a start that was. And now going right back for the racing lane. Oh, beautiful air that almost cleared the racing lane completely. And nice air off the van. Damn, only 13 seconds in. Ooh, hit the wall there. And already off to an incredible start as we got some huge air off the step up there. And now going back for the buses. Oh, nice nose dive into the ground. And now what's it going to do? Oh, going to go for the backflip right away. We're not even a third away for the run. And beautifully done there so far. Man, what a run this is by Shatter. And now going to go for the buses. Oh, beautiful air. And clears the van. Didn't even touch it at all. Didn't even touch the ramp going down. And now going for the other buses. I mean the van. Oh, man, what a run this is. And now going for the racing lane. Oh, beautiful sky wheelie. Ooh, going for a wheelie. It had to come to a stop because it's getting close to the wall. Unbelievable so far. You dare off the double. And it gone to another crossbred. Final 30 seconds. More nice air off the van there. And now line up for the semi-trailer. Ooh, got one off the side a little bit. Gotta be careful. Oh, two wheels, nice save. Gotta be careful when you hit at full speed because you don't want that to happen. And gonna go right for a double. Oh, beautiful air. And I think that's the first time anyone's cleared it from that side. Now, what's it gonna do? Getting coffee close to sim backflip container. Oh, beautiful air off the racing lane. Oh my god, what a run this is. Gonna right up the step up some more. And now in bonus time, and gonna combo it up to the van stack. Try to jump over the other one, but didn't line up perfectly. More beautiful air off the buses there. So now what's it gonna do? Oh, it's gonna go for another backflip. Are you kidding me? How many of them have we had tonight? Oh, that was really quick too. Went into the wall, and now gonna floor it right into the racing lane. Oh, the most biggest day of the night so far off that side. And now, ooh, stuffed into the step up. Got some more beautiful air. Ooh, hit the wall there. And oh, it did some damage there. But oh well, it filled the run. Couldn't keep on going, but holy shit, what a run that was by Shatter. That was its best run ever under this new scheme.
It's been, actually it wasn't that was a struggle, it's just that it wasn't doing at all incredible during freestyle because it focused more on racing. But damn, this is not only going to probably take the lead over Madness, but this is probably going to be leading for a while, and it will take the lead, a 31 regulation, 3 bonus points, and Shatter will take the lead with a 34. And now here comes Destroyer on the track, who was runner-up in racing, would love nothing more than get revenge on Shatter for knocking out racing, and to actually put up a good freestyle, which is has struggled all year to do. But as we all know, Destroyer's going to drive around the track first, so let's just sit back and wait for the moment to start. A little odd not going for the step up, but gonna go right for the racing on Bustag and got some nice, beautiful air there. So now what will it do? Lines up, ooh, nice turn there. Gonna go right for the Vans. Oh, beautiful air on that side. And now gonna go right for the racing, the double, tabletop. Oh, go upside on two needles, nice save. Ooh, slid off a bit, almost went to the double, backed up into the tabletop, and now gonna go onto the double. Man, that was a really risky there. And now gonna go right for the semi trailer. Oh, beautiful skywheel there. Oh no, going offside. Oh no, with the wheels. Oh no, going over. Oh man, the trouble still continues for Destroyer and Freestyle. Oh man. And it's only gonna be an 8 for Destroyer, which is now dead last. Well, here comes Pokemon! And now here comes Pokemon, the final truck of the night to start celebrating its 20th anniversary. With a beautiful Skywheel, another Metal Militia jump. Oh, nice start there, but got trouble there as it did not aim up for the tabletop as it probably wanted. Now it's going to line up for the double and going to clear it beautifully as it goes off the side a bit. Oh, nice air off the racing lane. Oh, hit the wall there. But doesn't seem to do any damage that would shut down, so it's going to keep going. Score to beat a 34 by Shatter. Off to an incredible start this year. This run. Nice air off the racing lane. Struggled all year in freestyle, flipping way too early, but so far doing it right. Oh, more beautiful air off the buses. And now gonna, always gonna go for the van, but missed it. But now it looks like it's gonna do a perfect spinning lineup perfectly for it. As we're now halfway through the run, I'm sure Shatter's getting a little nervous. Now it's gonna do a spin around and gonna go right for the backflip container, and what a bounce that was. It landed right on the front and bounced back up on the rear end. How about that? And now gonna line up for the race lane again. More beautiful air, and now it's gonna go for the Vans over there, and it's gonna try and combo it over the Vans, but didn't quite do it properly. Oh, nice air off the buses, and lands actually right on the racing lane, center jump. How about that? And now gonna go back for the double some more, and just plants right on the vent. The buses beautifully. And now gonna go right for the semi-trailer. Nice sky, landing there. Oh, gonna reverse up the semi-trailer. How about that? As we're now in bonus time, and that counted for bonus time as well. And now what will it do? Gonna land it all in the air, and actually lands on the wall. How about that? Man, what a finish that was. Now you know why all the barriers are up there. Oh, another backflip too. Man, what a run this is by Pokemon! Oh my god, this is great! More beautiful air off the van! The buses clears the Vans! Better hurry, it will not count towards the score. It's very close.
But that's it. Two wheels. Nice save. That was it in terms of scoring two before it went up to Vance. Like, oh no, I'm on the side again. Another save. Man, off to a great start so far. Not supposed to reverse, but there's no longer scoring, so it doesn't matter. What an incredible run this is, trying to get as much speed as possible off the tabletop there. Oh, beautifully crushes the van some more. I can't believe Pokemon is still going. 20th anniversary and trying to make up for that terrible performance mostly this year. Hope to try and make it to the championship, but fell short because of fucking up so much. And now line up for the bus some more. And another crossbred as it nose dives into the ground. And now gonna go for the semi-trail. Crooked, uh-oh, just better be careful, but nope, didn't go over here. And now gonna go into Thunder Alley, hit the barriers, and now coming right back out. Gonna go right up that semi-trailer again at an odd angle. Man, what an incredible run this is, going right for the buses. Oh, gonna step into it! On two wheels! And a sucker! What a save that was! Oh my god, that's probably the best save in a long time by MTWS. What an incredible run this is! Damn, that was the best save since Impala in New Orleans last year. They got a nice air off the vans. Now what will Pokemon do? Gonna go right for the double some more. And lands right on top of the racing lane. And now gonna go for Vance. Oh, going off the side on a wheelie. Going over. Finally going over after that incredible run there. Unbelievable start to Pokemon's 20th anniversary. And remember, in just less than a month, will be Pokemon's 20th anniversary Monster Truck event. I'm sure hopefully all of you can't wait to see that. But now, will this be enough to take out Shatter's 34 and prevent it from getting the stubble down? And it will! A 33 in regulation, 3 bonus points, and Pokemon will win with a 36!
Well, congratulations to Pokemon winning its first ever freestyle. And how about that in the Runners-Up Cup, too? And how about Shatter almost double down, which has not happened ever in Runners-Up Cup history. Everyone did a very good job in freestyle, except Destroyer and Nightstalker. Everyone else got pretty high scores. So everyone did a pretty good job. So now here's the results for freestyle. And now, the moment we all been waiting for. Time to seed the bracket for the 2015 Championship Racing Park. And now, here is the bracket. And ja-ja! Here's the top part of the bracket. As you can see, it'll be the first race will be Wild Ride versus Outrage. And then it'll be Bling versus Crazy. And then the first big showdown round will be Eruption versus Flying Falcon. And then it'll be Impala versus Crusher. Wild Rider Outrage will face Outlaw, Ling or Crazy will face Mad Dog, Eruption or Flying Falcon will face Patriot, and Impala or Crusher will face Crush and Run. And then on the bottom part of the bracket, we'll have the Monster Razor versus Stinger, and whoever wins will face the rookie Monster Jam. And then Nitro and Red Alert will go up against each other, and the winner will face Fireball. And then it'll be Prowler versus Crazy Bull, that'll be pretty big. Again, the winner will face Blood Rage. And then finally, the last race would be Power Forward versus Shadow Run, and whoever wins will face Thunderbolt. So that's the racing bracket for the 2015 championship. Well, now as you see, I updated the logo for the championship. So for the final time, congratulations Destroyer for getting number one qualifying, congratulations Shatter for winning racing, and congratulations Pokemon for winning freestyle.
And now, just tune in next week as we crown the 2015 champions. Will Crush and Run and Nitro defend their title? Or will one of the 23 other trucks get them? Or who knows, maybe they'll actually flip. Who knows, anything will happen. For all I know, it'll be some incredible racing and beautiful freestyle destruction next week. So, until then, Zanny.